In this video, I will go over the idea behind exact equations. However, before I talk about this, let me ask you guys, for review purpose, what is a differential equation? Well, simple, right? It's just an equation that has a derivative. And now, let's think back to Calc 1. How do we get the derivative? Well, ideally speaking, you want the y to be isolated and all the x is on the other side and can just go ahead and differentiate, right? And let me give you guys an example. Suppose we have y is equal to x squared. That's everybody's favorite derivative equation, right? Well, differentiate that, you get dy dx is equal to 2x. And there you have it, that is a differential equation. And you should know how to solve that differential equation, right? However, what if the y is not isolated? And let me give you guys an example. Suppose we have this right here, x to the second power, y to the fourth power, and we add it with cosine of y, and let me tell you, this is equal to 1. Alright, the y is not isolated, and in fact, no matter what we do, we cannot isolate the y. But we can still get the derivative, right? We can still get the dy dx. We can do so by using the implicit differentiation. Let's go ahead and do that. So let me put down dx and open the parentheses like this. This is telling us we are going to differentiate this equation with respect to x. And that's to get the first part. This is the product of two functions, so we have to use the product rule. So let me put down the first function, which is x squared, and we multiply by the derivative of y to the fourth power. Bring the 4 to the front, subtract 1, keep the y, so we have 4y to the third power. However, because the chain rule, we know the derivative y is going to be dy dx, right? It's because y is a function of x. So we have to multiply by dy dx. And that's how we squeeze out the dy dx. And when we continue with the product rule, we add the second function, which is y to the fourth power, and we multiply by the derivative of x squared. The derivative of x squared with respect to x is simply just 2x. So you multiply by 2x. And this is it, right, for that. Right, differentiate cosine y. The derivative cosine is negative sine, so let me put on negative sine, and then the input stays the same. Once again, the chain rule says we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside. The derivative y is dy dx. At the end, this is equal to 0 because of the derivative 1 is just 0. And now we are done with the implicit differentiation. Of course, we want to isolate the dy dx. And we see that this term and this term, they both have the dy dx. And I want to keep them on the left-hand side. And I will move this to the other side. Since both of them have dy dx, I'm going to factor d out. And let me tell you, when you factor out the dy dx, put it at the end of the parentheses. Do not put down the dy dx in the front, because when you do that, it looks like this. It looks like you're about to differentiate it again. But no, dy dx is what we're trying to solve already. This is an operation that tells you to differentiate this equation, okay? Therefore, let me just open a parenthesis. I will write this down as 4x squared y to the third power. This is about to be factored out, okay? So there's nothing left. And I will write down minus sine of y, close parenthesis, okay? I will factor both of them right here, which is dy dx. Put it at the end, okay? And this is equal to, bring this to the other side, we have minus 2x goes first, y to the fourth power, like this. Divide, like that. At the end, we get dy dx, and now give us that, negative 2x, y to the fourth power, over the whole thing right over there, 4x squared, y to the third power, and we minus sine of y, and we are done. This is a derivative, and it's also a differential equation, right? Well, here's the question. What if this is the differential equation that we're trying to solve? How can you go back from here back to this? Well, if you look at the steps in the reversed order, I don't think it's easy to see how to go back from here to here, and then back to here, and then back to there. So, how can we do that then? First of all, we know that this right here, it must have an answer because this right here is the answer, right? But the steps, how can I go back from here to here if somebody erased everything? I don't know, right? So here's the deal. This is the calc-1 method. Let me write this down for you guys. This is the calc-1 method of getting the derivative right here, right? And in fact, this is not the form that I want to look at. If you look at this equation here, on the left-hand side, this is just a function in terms of both x and y. It's a multivariable function, right? And in calc-3, we have also seen how to deal with this kind of situation. So now, let's talk about the calc-3 situation. Let's talk about the calc-3 method of getting the derivative from here. Right here, let me just label this. This is the calc-3 part. Like a quick review, okay? On the left-hand side, arguably, it's just a function in both x and y. We will write this down as capital F of x and y, like this. And usually, we like to bring all the constant to the right-hand side. So we will look at this and make this equal to a constant c, okay? Well, to get the derivative right here with the calc-3 method, we have to talk about what we mean by the total differential. So let me write this down right here for you guys. Total differential. And there's a nice formula for that. And it involves partial derivative. And let me write this down. df, okay? This is the total differential. What we do is, we'll do the partial, I'll put this on red. The partial of f with respect to x first. And then we multiply this by dx. And we add it with the partial of capital F with respect to y, and we multiply this by dy. This is the total differential. Okay, what's the function? Well, this right here is the function. And let's do some partial derivative, okay? So let me write this down. We will have the function, which is f of xy is that x squared y to the fourth power plus cosine of y, and you know this is equal to 1, but at the end you'll get 0 because the derivative 1 is just 0. So anyways, so now let's look at df. First of all, this is the function part, and I want to get my partial f with respect to x. This means x is the variable, y is the constant, okay? So for this term right here, we will just bring the 2 to the front. We have 2x. That's it, right? Because that's just the function part. This is the constant. When you differentiate, the constant pretty much just stays. So we have y to the fourth power. But if you look at this right here, do the partial with respect to x. This is technically a constant. When you differentiate this with respect to x, this disappears to be 0, right? So we are done. This is just partial of f with respect to x right here. And we multiply by dx. Next, we add the partial of f with respect to y, so look at this right here. Okay, this time, the y is the variable, the x is the constant. Let me put down the constant first, which is x squared, right? And y is the variable, differentiate this, we bring the 4 to the front, subtract 1, so we have y to the third power, like this. Okay, this is the derivative for that part. Next, we differentiate this, cosine y, with respect to y, we get negative sine of y. All right? The whole thing here is the partial of f with respect to y, and we multiply by dy. Okay? And on the right hand side, the derivative of 1 is just 0. So, this is it. And now let me ask you, is this the same as that? Well, let's make them look exactly the same. Right here, I'll keep this on the left-hand side, so I'll open the parentheses right here. 4x squared y to the third power minus sine of y, and we have the dy right here. And this is equal to, we bring this to the right-hand side, so be sure you subtract, okay? Minus 2x y to the fourth power dx. And next, we will just divide dx on both sides and divide that on both sides, right? So you will see dy dx is equal to this on the top, negative 2x y to the fourth power, and this goes down in the denominator over 4x squared y to the third power minus sine of y. So you guys can see that this and that are the same. This is the Calvin way to get the dy dx, and this is the Calvin way of getting that dy dx. Okay? You can let me know in the comment down below which way that you like better. And let me tell you, in order for us to solve this differential equation, we are going to be looking at this form right here. Okay? This is the form that we'll be looking at. And in fact, we also have to use this idea with a total differential. So this is the main thing that I want to tell you. This is the idea behind the exact equation. And now let's go over how we can solve this equation. And you see that I wrote down this equation this way, right? I didn't write it down like this. However, if this is the form that you're getting on the test, be sure you do some algebra to make sure you have this form. Something times dx plus something times dy is equal to 0 in order for this procedure to work. And now let me emphasize, we know this right here has an answer, right? And we know this right here came from the total differential form from this function. This is exactly from the total differential form, right? And I think this is the reason why this kind of equation is called the exact equation. I'm not sure though, don't quote me on that. And however, sometimes when you are getting this kind of equation in this form, this may not be exact. So you have to watch my next video. I will have to show you how to check for exactness. But for this one, let me just demonstrate the procedures, okay? And with that being said, since we know this came from the total differential form, that's important, and this is the exact equation, okay? This right here is going to be partial f with respect to x, right? And likewise, for this right here, it must be partial f with respect to y. And here is the deal. No, just choose one of them to begin with. Let me pick this one to begin with. Let me write this down that we know partial f with respect to x is equal to 2x y to the fourth power, okay? I am not putting down the dx right here yet. Let me just write this down. This is what we have. And now just do things backwards. Well, I want to figure out the capital F. That's the answer, right? That's the answer for that. This is partial, which is just a derivative. To cancel the derivative, we have to integrate. Let's integrate both sides. In this case, we are going to integrating with respect to x, okay? We are integrating with respect to x. On the left-hand side, we'll get the capital F. I'm not going to put on plus c, you know the deal. This is equal to, do this carefully, we are doing the integral in the x world, so x is the variable, okay? So, just pretty much look at this. We have to add 1 to the exponent, so that will be 2. We have x to the second power. And divided by 2, 2 divided by 2 is just 1, so we have x squared. Y to the fourth power is a constant, so we can just put that down like this. That's it, okay? If you differentiate this with respect to x, you'll get that. All right, we are done with the integration part. Usually we add a constant. However, we are doing partial derivatives right here, right? This right here, we are dealing with multivariable. I don't know if I can say partial integral, but whatever. Anyways, in the x world, y is a constant. When we do this right here, we are not just going to be adding a constant. We are going to be adding a function of y, because a function of y in the x world was considered to be a constant, right? So if you differentiate this with respect to x, this will be going away. So this is how the f will look like. And if you look at this right here, we are almost done, but let's not look at the answer. Well, now, how can I figure out the function of y that we're missing, though? We have to utilize this right here. That's how we can make all the connections. Based on this, we know the partial f with respect to y has to be that, right? So look at this f equation. I'm going to do the partial derivative with respect to y. And of course, we do this on both sides. Let me just write it down like this on both sides. On the left-hand side, we will have the partial of f with respect to y. And this is going to give us the partial with respect to y of the first term right here. This is a constant, I'll write it down. Y to the fourth power, bring the 4 to the front, y to the third power, huh? And when we differentiate this with respect to y, this is the function in terms of y, so we will get, I don't know what f is, so I'll just write down f prime of x, f prime of y. Okay, we're using y right here. All right, now this is the form of partial of f of with respect to y. This must match that, right? And you see, this and that are the same. That means this has to be the same as negative sine y. And let me write down the idea for you guys. I'm going to set this equal to what the partial of f with respect to y should be. So I'll write this down, 4x to the second power, 4x to the second power, y to the third power, minus sine of y. And from here, we see that f prime of y must be the same as negative sine y. So I can write this down. F prime of y has to be negative sine of y. And of course, here we can just integrate both sides with respect to y. So put on dy right here. On the left-hand side, and you see this right here, little f is just a function in terms of y only. So we just get the f, okay? F of y, and put this down like this. On the right-hand side, the integral of negative sine y in the y world is just positive cosine y. The derivative of this is that. And we are going to add c. This is just a innocent, the ordinary, the constant c that you know. It's not another function in terms of x, because little f prime of y, right? You know this right here, you're just talking about a function in terms of y. There's no x at all. Capital F has both x and y. All right, so this is what we have. So at the end, you see capital F was that. So I just have to write this down right here. Capital F, and I'll write this down as x squared. Right, this is the form I'm looking at. X squared, y to the fourth power. F of y is this. So I put down plus cosine of y. And here's the deal. This is the function part. And you see, I can put on plus c if you would like. And you can just say this is equal to 0 because that's original, you have the 0, right? However, here's how we do it. You just put a c on the right-hand side. So if you would like, you can call that c1. And this is the legitimate c. Always put a c on the right-hand side. So the thing is, just figure out the function part. That's the main deal. See that? This is the function that we got right here. Of course, we have this c. Well, earlier we have 1. Well, how can we solve for c? You have to tell me an initial value, right? So, before I erase, just take a look of this right here once again. And now this is gone. Suppose we have this initial value. As usual, you know that here is the x, here is the y. Plug in into this right here, right? And let me open a parenthesis for you guys first. We take square root of 2 over pi squared, and we square that for the x, and we multiply by y to the fourth power. Y is pi, so we have pi to the fourth power, and then we add it with cosine of pi, and this is equal to the constant. Well, let's just work this out, and we can figure out what the constant is. This right here, square root of 2 squared is just a 2 over pi squared, and the square is pi to the fourth power times pi to the fourth power. And then we know that cosine of pi is negative 1. This is what we have, and this is equal to c. And you see, pi to the fourth power cancel with pi to the fourth power. All in all, we have 2 minus 1 equals to c. Of course, c is equal to 1. And finally, you can just put that down, right? So we have x squared y to the fourth power plus cosine of y is equal to 1. And here we have it. This is how we solve an exact equation. Be sure to watch the next video because I have to show you how to check if an equation like this is indeed exact or not. Otherwise, this procedure won't work.